Hi again. It's time to keep my promise and publish the RoboEyes library on GitHub. I finally managed to upload
version number 1
and to create this video for you. I'll now show you everything to get started and we'll go through the available methods. Here we go. Step 1. Prepare basic hardware circuit. You'll need a breadboard, an Arduino Nano R3 or compatible microcontroller, an I2C OLED display with 1306 or 1309 driver chip, and obviously some jumper wires will enable us to connect all the stuff. Now add the Arduino and connect its 5V output to the breadboard's plus line. Similarly, connect the Arduino's ground to the breadboard's minus line. It always makes life easier to also connect the plus and minus lines with their respective lines on the opposite side. Add the display and connect the ground and voltage pins. Connect the serial clock and serial data pins to the regarding I2C pins of your microcontroller. On the Arduino Uno or Nano R3, use analog 4 for SDA and analog 5 for SCK or SCL. Step 2. Get started with the library. Navigate to the RoboEyes GitHub repository. You'll find the link in the description. Then choose Code, Download Zip. In the Arduino IDE, go to Sketch, Include Library, Add Zip Library, and select the downloaded file. Once this is done, go to File, Examples, Flux Garage RoboEyes, and open the I2C Basics. This sketch starts with the basic declarations that come with the Adafruit display driver. Make sure that the correct pixel resolution of your OLED display is defined here. Then the RoboEyes library is included and an instance with the name RoboEyes is created. Use this instance name as the prefix when calling any of the library's methods. In the setup, we're starting up the serial and the display. Depending on your specific display, the I2C address will be most likely 0x3C or 0x3D. If things don't work as expected, try to change this address first. Now we're starting up the RoboEyes by calling the begin method, handing over the screen width and screen height as defined above. Also, we're setting the maximum frame rate, which makes sense for fast controllers to slow down the animation speed if necessary. For this first test, let's add some life by simply setting up the auto blinker and the idle mode macro animators. Set auto blinker, turn it on, add the minimum blink interval in full seconds plus the range for an additional random value also in full seconds. In this example, the eyes will blink every 3 to 5 seconds. For the idle mode, it works similarly. Set idle mode, turn it on, and define the minimum interval plus the range for an additional random value in full seconds. Here, the eyes will be randomly repositioned every 2 to 4 seconds. As you see, this example contains lots of more method calls that are currently commented out. Let's ignore them for now. We'll go through them in a moment. In the main loop, we just need to add the hook that draws the animation frames. Now upload the sketch to your Arduino. If you can then look into a pair of friendly robot eyes, we are good to tackle the details. If not, post a comment and me and the community will try to help you. Step 3. Create custom eye shapes. Each robot has its own personality and this should be represented in his or her face. It's completely up to you to create a typical robot or some weird freak that stands out from the crowd. You can set the width, the height, and the border radius for each eye by defining the respective pixel values as arguments for the left and the right eye. Also, you can set the space between the eyes. If you want to have a circular shape, choose common values for width and height plus a border radius value that is nearly half of this width or height. The value for the space between can be negative if you want the eyes to be melded together. And of course, both eyes can be different if you want so. If your robot should have only one eye, turn the Cyclops mode on. Step 4. Use face expressions and define behavior. Now that we have created our unique eye shapes, it's time to deal with the eye's behavior. Set the robot's mood to tired, angry, happy, or back to default. Probably there will be more mood types available in the future. To change the eye's position, use the setPosition method with the abbreviation of any cardinal direction as an argument, such as north, northeast, east, southeast, and so on. Default will position the eyes horizontally and vertically centered. Make sure that the idle mode is off, so that it won't override the positions you've set. If you want the robot to be curious, meaning the height of the outer eyes increases when moving to the very left or very right, just turn the curious mode on. To add a horizontal flicker, call the setHflicker method, turn it on, and type in a pixel value for the amplitude. For a vertical flicker, this works similarly with the setVflicker method. Horizontal and vertical flickers can also be combined. And as the final example, let's trigger the confused animation or the laugh animation. Enough theory for today. I hope you'll enjoy playing around with this library. If you have any questions, suggestions, or want to share some experience with us, just post a comment. And sure, likes are always appreciated. What comes next? Until here, we've made all the definitions in the sketch setup, meaning we've defined the eye's initial state. In contrast to that, all changes in time need to take place in the main loop, but without using the delay function. Such animation sequences will be part of the next video. Also, I'll prepare some shots that deal with sensor readings and the corresponding robot behavior. So stay tuned, subscribe to this channel, and see you soon!